All right. Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. Tonight, as usual, we are going to worship the Lord, not just from our lips, but from the depths of our hearts. I'd like us to lift our hands tonight as we begin to worship this wonderful, this glorious God, this dependable Father. He's so reliable. God is so dependable. He's our God and our Maker. Father, Lord, we thank you. Daddy, we bless your name tonight. King of glory, we worship you. Thank you, King of kings. Thank you, Lord of lords. You are worthy to be praised. The bright and the morning star, we worship you. King of glory, we exalt your holy name. You are worthy. You alone are worthy to be praised. You alone are worthy to be magnified and exalted. Lord, we lift our voices tonight. We thank you and we exalt and bless your name for what you are doing in our lives. We are seeing your mighty hand. Your voice is leading us. Lord, your spirit is working excellently in our lives. Your spirit is working excellently in our lives. Therefore, Lord, tonight we worship you. We'll give you all the praise. We give you all the glory. We exalt and magnify your name. Oh, be thou exalted, O God. Be thou magnified. Be thou glorified. Father, we thank you. Lord, we bless your name. Oh, wherever you are, can we just, let's gather ourselves together. Let's join our spirit. Let's join the 24 elders in heaven to worship this wonderful God. This evening, let's worship him. Let's worship him. Let's worship him. You are awesome in this place. Mighty God. Oh, Jesus, you are worthy to be praised. You are some in this place. Abba Father, you are worthy of the Lord. Let's just worship this up. This wonderful God, let's exalt his holy name. Let's magnify him. Daddy, you are worthy to be praised. Jehovah, you are worthy to be praised. King of kings, you are worthy to be praised. Lord of lords, you are worthy to be praised. Daddy, you are worthy to be praised. We see what you are doing in our lives. Therefore, King of glory, tonight, we have come to exalt your holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Let's take this song once again. Let's take another one very quickly because of our time. It's a Yoruba song, and I want us to sing it from the depth of our hearts tonight, so that Christ will be exalted and will be praised. Ope loye, babe lore, iyi ogoye, olorun oba, osana ya. Eshe o baba ope loye baba lore yin ogoye olorun oba osana ya eshe o baba. Lord, you are wholesome in this place. Therefore, we lift up our hands. We lift up our voices tonight, Lord, to say thank you.
that it will bless and to exalt your holy name. Thank you for pardoning all our iniquities. Thank you for washing away all our sins. Thank you, King of Glory, for your new covenant in our lives. We give you praise, we give you glory. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty and glorious name, we have given thanks. Hallelujah. Very quickly, we are going to pray tonight. And I title today's prayers meeting, as we have a wonderful team for the month that we have been dwelling on now for like two, three weeks. All right? And this is the first week. We have wonderful covenant that says, that says, covenant remembrance for manifestation. All right? Covenant remembrance for manifestation. And under this, I have a glorious topic this evening, that I would like us to pray with. Wonderful topic. And it says, I'm going to be putting it to you, just like what we have in the book of Jeremiah 32, verse 27. It's like a question. You know, the word of the Lord came to us there, and it says, I am the God of all flesh. Is anything too hard for me to do? Full stop. He wants us to deliberately answer the question. So our topic this morning is similar to that. I'm going to be putting it to you as a question. And it says, after God remembering his covenant, take note of that. After God remembering his covenant, what's next? Or after his remembrance, what's next? And we were told, you know, from the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 15, verse 15 of it, that I read to you the other time, that at the end, when the people engage themselves into the covenant, we were told of what happened. It was peace galore. It was peace all around. So after God's remembering his covenant, what next? After God's remembering his covenant, what next? What should follow? Number one is peace. Number two, abundance. Number three, success. After God's covenant, the fellow should be able to experience peace, success, expansion, and so on and so forth. Now we need to check our lives, because after God's remembrance, if all these things are not happening, then we need to sit down and ask questions. I was sharing with somebody on Sunday, you know, I said, I don't just pray. Because the person was, we're just rubbing minds together, and the person said that it's not just good to pray, that after prayer we need to watch, which is true. And I said to him, I don't just pray, I like praying. But after praying and after my prayers, what I always do, if I wait and I didn't see answer to my prayers, I go to God straight away and say, God, I ask you for this and I ask you for that. How come I'm not getting it? Then he tells me what to do. So what we are saying is that after God's covenant, there is something that needs to follow. And what is it? One of it is what I've just rightly said. peace, abundance, success. So that is why we need to check our lives. Because by the power in the name of Jesus, whether Satan likes it or not, after this God's covenant in our lives, after this God's covenant in our lives, peace galore shall be our portion in Jesus' name. Very quickly, I would like us to start with Nigeria. This evening, I would like us to pray for Nigeria that the peace of God should reign in the name of Jesus. Lord, wherever you are, just lift your hands and begin to pray that prayer. Lord, by your power, by your glory, King of glory, by your grace, O God, collectively and individually, Daddy, we pray, we lift up our voices tonight. We ask, O God, that peace will reign in this country. This country of ours, this country, this Nigeria, Lord, peace will reign in the name of the Lord Jesus. Lord, let peace begin to reign in every area and in every corner. In the name of the Lord Jesus, don't forget that the election has started already. I want us to pray for the peace, that the peace of God will reign supreme in this country. In the name of the Lord Jesus, Libra kota tu, Libra kata te topa sutalia, Libra katu kata. Lord, we pray down your peace. In the name of the Lord Jesus, the Bible says, blessed are those that are praying for their country. They will enjoy the fruit of the land. This Jehovah will pray by your power, by your glory tonight, that your peace will begin to reign in the name of the Lord Jesus. Thank you that we are blessed and Redeemer. We give you praise, we give you glory. In Jesus' mighty and glorious name, we are praying. I want to read 2 Chronicles 15, verse 15. And I would like us to pray that prayer once again. Hallelujah. Look at this country called Nigeria. Some of these things are not working. Some of our things that needs to be working, they are not working. Therefore, I would like us to pray very, very well for this country. 2 Chronicles 15, verse 15. And all Judea rejoiced at the oath, for they had sworn with all their heart and sought him with their whole desire. And he was found of them, and the Lord gave them rest round about. So, Lord, my Father, this country of ours, this very Nigeria, Lord, give us rest round about. In the name of the Lord Jesus, open your mouth and pray that prayer. Daddy, we pray tonight by your power, by your glory. Peace. Peace. In the name of Jesus, we decree and declare peace. Thank you, our blessed Redeemer. We give you praise, we give you glory. In Jesus' mighty and glorious name, we are praying. Very quickly, let's read the book of Psalms 71, verse 21. Like I was sharing with us, that after God's remembrance, what next? Peace is number one. Then number two, abundance, surplus, and success should follow. Now, let's play with this Psalms 71, verse 21. He says, thou shalt increase my greatness and comfort me on every side. This can only be the portion of a person who is into a covenant with God. When somebody engages himself as self proper into a covenant of God, this should fall in place. This should happen in the person's life. All right? The person must experience increment and expansion. Increasement and expansion. Extension. Success and blessing. Therefore, I want us to pray tonight from the depth of our heart. I want you to lift your hands and ask God, Lord, by your power, by your glory, increase my greatness and comfort me on every side because of your covenant working expressly in my life. Open your mouth and pray that prayer. Libro sukale mrukali lindrugidabo satala limbratina liprako minasuntali. Lord, by your power, by your grace, O God, you will increase our greatness and comfort us on every side. Lord, we ask for your increment on all sides. We ask for your expansion on all sides. In the name of the Lord Jesus, increase our greatness and comfort us on all sides. In the name of the Lord Jesus, by your power, by your glory, this will be our portion. Thank you because you've heard us, Lord. We give you praise, we give you glory. In Jesus' mighty and glorious name, we are praying. Once again, we're still praying without very fast. And chapter Psalm 71, verse 21. I want us to pray for the church. I want us to ask God deliberately tonight that, Lord, you will increase our greatness as a church and you will comfort us on every side. Let's open our mouth and pray that prayer. Lumbrakata, Lord, by your power, by your glory, by your grace, O God, Jehovah, you will comfort us on all sides. You will comfort your church at every side and on every side. And you will increase our greatness in the name of the Lord Jesus. By your power, by your glory, Lord, we receive this from the throne of grace. In the name of the Lord Jesus, Daddy, we receive this from the throne of grace. In the name of the Lord Jesus, thank you, our blessed Redeemer. We give you praise, we give you glory. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty and glorious name, we are praying. The next prayer point I'd like us to pray, I'd like us to see Genesis chapter 1 very quickly. We want to read from probably verses 1 to 3. Genesis chapter 1. And I'd like us to pray, you know, very, very well with that verse 3. And it says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God said, let there be light. And there was light. After God's remembrance, what should follow in the life of that person should be light. The light. The light of heaven. The light of heaven. Therefore, we are going to pray. We are going to ask God tonight and say, Father, from this moment as a child, we receive your light from the throne of grace. We will begin to enjoy your light in every area, in every facet of our lives. Let's open our mouth and pray that prayer. Daddy, we pray tonight by your power, by your glory, light, light of heaven. In all that concerns us, in all that we are doing, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord, light in all our endeavors, in the name of the Lord Jesus, let your light begin to shine, in the name of Jesus, Lord, let your light begin to shine. God said, let there be light, and there was light. Lord, we receive your light this morning, based on the new covenant. In the name of the Lord Jesus, based on that platform of covenant, platform of new covenant. Lord, we receive your light. Daddy, we receive your light based on that platform. That new King of Glory, new covenant, we receive in the name of Jesus. Daddy, we receive your light in the name of Jesus. Jehovah, we receive your light in the name of Jesus. Thank you because you've heard us, Lord. We give you praise, we give you glory. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty and glorious name, we are praying. Lastly, I want us to pray because it is possible for somebody to be in a covenant with God today and tomorrow no more. I want us to pray that this covenant of God in our lives will be permanent. We will not just be into a covenant today and tomorrow, we are no more. It is necessary and very essential for us to have a covenant with God and for us to remain in a covenant so that peace unspeakable can continue in our lives. Therefore, I want us to pray. Lord, this new covenant you've already had with our lives, Lord, shall be permanent in Jesus' name. Let's open our mouth and pray that prayer. Lord, by your power, by your glory, this covenant shall be permanent. This new covenant, King of Glory, that you have already had with us, will be permanent. It shall be permanent in the name of the Lord Jesus. It shall be permanent in the name of Jesus. This covenant of peace, this covenant of success, this covenant of breakthroughs, this covenant of expansion and extension shall be permanent in our lives in the name of the Lord Jesus. Lord, it shall be permanent in our homes. It shall be permanent in the name of Jesus. Thank you, our blessed Redeemer. We give you praise, we give you glory. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty and glorious name, we have prayed. Thanks. Thanks, we give you thanks, for you have done in our lives. We are so blessed, our souls have found rest. Praise God, we give you thanks. Lord, we give you thanks, 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 Daddy. We give you thanks, for you have done in our lives. We are so blessed, our souls are fast. Praise God. We give you thanks. Shall we just lift our hands to heaven and begin to thank him? Let's worship and exalt his holy name once again. Lord, so Father, we thank you. Lord, we bless the name. We give you all the praise. We give you glory. We give you honor. You alone are worthy to be praised. King of Glory, we appreciate you tonight. Lord, we exalt your holy name. You alone are worthy. Thank you, King of Kings. Thank you, Lord of Lords. Oh, the bread of life, we thank you. The only wisdom, the wisdom of heaven, Daddy, we thank you. We worship you. The only wise God, we worship you. Be thou exalted. Be thou glorified. Be thou magnified. Jude 1:25 tells us the last verse. Introduces God to us as the only wise God. The only wise God, we appreciate you. Lord, tonight we worship you. Be thou exalted. Be thou magnified. Be thou glorified. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty and glorious name, we have prayed. All right, now listen to this prophecy very quickly. You know, there is power in the world. John chapter 6, verse 63, Jesus said, "The word that I speak to you, they are not just ordinary words. They are spirit and they are life. They are spirit and they are life. The word is powerful. Through the word, the word is being framed. Therefore, I am standing in my office as a representative of God, as a figure of the Almighty God, and by the power invested in me by the Holy Ghost, I decree and declare into your lives and your destinies, in the name of Jesus, the rest of your life, the peace of God, the peace of Jehovah, that knows no limits, shall come mightily upon you in the name of Jesus. I pray and I decree once again, by the power of heaven, what you are doing, that business or those business in your hands, in the name of Jehovah, the Lord will breathe on it in the name of Jesus. The breath of Jesus came upon two fishes and just five loaves of bread. And as a result of that, the Bible recalls that 5,000 men, besides women and children, were fed. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, the breath of heaven shall come mightily upon your ministry, your business, your finances, and all that concerns you in the name of Jesus. Thank you because you've heard us, Lord. We give you praise. We give you glory. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty and glorious name, we have prayed and we'll continue praising you forever in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. The Lord bless you and bless your country, Nigeria, in Jesus' name.